Yo, yo, what's going on, peoples? How you doing? It's 11:30, Monday, July 3rd. I hope everybody is excited to have the day off. There's no trading tomorrow in the markets, and so we shall celebrate Independence Day with hopefully some family time or whatever it is that you guys choose to do. But I want to take a second and get you guys a little bit of homework or a little bit of something to watch for the July 4th in case you're sitting around and have some free time. You know, right now, what we're seeing in the market is a sector rotation, right? So what sector rotation means is where the money flows from one sector to another. So right now what you're seeing is a lot of money actually flowing out of the tech sector, which has been the hottest sector really for the last couple years. You can see here, you know, we've been on like really this epic trend in the tech sector here. And the last, you know, couple weeks, we're starting to see money flow out of that. You can see it via the volume, right? And just the distribution that's happening in regular stocks, Google, Tesla, AAOI, NVIDIA, a lot of the hot stocks that, you know, we've spent the last year and 2 years trading. They're starting to roll over, and you're starting to see that money flow into other sectors. And so that's a healthy thing, guys. Every year, you don't want to be pounding the same sector, right? You want to see money flow over and from one sector to another so you get fresh charts, fresh new uptrends that are not tired, right? You want to be, you know, you want to catch, you know, you want to catch the NVIDIAs, right, as they're starting to accelerate, right? You know, you could see, like, we started trading this thing back in the 40s and 50s, and you could see, like, the epic trend that it's been on, right? And so, you know, we want to find the next one of those. And so you're starting to see that rotation into a lot of names. But in the meantime, while that's happening, of course, we're getting some epic shorts in that distribution. So the tech sector is going under distribution, and there's been some just amazing shorts that we've been able to do playing that tech sector fade. So, you know, today, like, I made about $1,800. I'm shorting some tech stocks, and then I ripped about $2,500 in futures shorting the tech sector, NQ. And so really the same setup for both. So where I took my short today was in NVIDIA. And you can see with NVIDIA what's happening is this stock is – having this huge rollover. So after this epic run, you know, it's coming back and it's having a little bit of distribution, and probably today was probably its last down day for a little bit. It should bounce in the next, you know, couple days close to here. But we've been shorting this thing for the last so many days as it's just getting distributed in the tech sector. So one of the things that you'll notice is with the market is that, you know, today the market actually gapped up the tech sector. Okay, and what happens is when a sector gaps up and it's going under distribution, when a sector gaps up when it's under distribution, those gaps will often fade. And so you're seeing a huge distribution in that tech. So it means that the strength becomes a liquidity event, right? People use the strength in the market to sell their positions. They say, oh, I got some green finally in this stock or the market. Because it's been going down so much, and so they sell, and then the selling begets more selling. And so when I saw this gap up in the markets, you know, I knew right off the bat that that's most likely just the distribution due to the location and what's been happening in the tech sector. And so, you know, right off the bat, you know, our first trade of the day, I'm shorting this NVIDIA, right? And so there's two clues here, okay, that, you know, we did. So I traded this back and forth a couple times here for 1266. But there's two clues here that are very, very important. Well, number one is the tech sector gapped up, and then the gap started fading off right off the bat. But look at where NVIDIA was. It didn't gap up. It opened up weak. So that's relative weakness right off the bat, right? And so while that tech sector popped, this one already started to make a move lower right off the bat. And so, you know, we've got some support here from the last couple days that, you know, I've been monitoring, you know, in case this thing was going to sell off again. And so, you know, this thing popped down, just ran into support from the previous day, and then it popped up into its EMAs. That's totally cool, right? It's too early to short it. I need it to test for a third time. You know, I like a level to hit for three times. And so when it comes back and breaks down on the second test of the day, which is the third test of that level, now I take myself short. And I, of course, anticipate. I like to short a little bit closer to the moving averages so I can manage my risk. So, you know, I got this thing at 144.50s in here. And then as it broke down, I added more. So I had like 300 shares, give or take, when I added the first time. And so you can see right off the bat, like, this thing just drops $3 or $2 and some change in a really hot second. And for me, I like to scale out. I'm always taking profits. I think part of it's just being Indian, we're cheap or whatever. But I like to take profits. And so, you know, first swoosh, I'll take off 100. Second swoosh, I'll take off 100. And then you can see what happens here is it bear flags. And so I add a few more shares, and then we're playing into that next dump. Guys, this is the thing. You don't have to have that many shares to make money, right? So, like, the guys that traded my fund, right? I have 157 of my students that trade inside the Click Fund that are graduates of the bootcamp student. I assign them capital. I give them the same platform that I use. I give them leverage where they can get, you know, up to $15,000 per position in buying power, and I allow them to trade for me, right? And so, like, a lot of these guys will have, you know, even right off the bat, you know, even with the smaller account, say they've got a $2,500, $5,000 account, they're allowed access to that buying power. So they can short 100, 200 shares of this and really, really catch some nice rips. And so you can play this thing to the downside. And now the key is, you know, once this type of flush happens, we want to short that first pop, right? We want to short that first pop. So this thing gets down to 139. When it pops up into the 9 EMA, I want to reshort. Now, I don't just reshort because it pops in the 9 EMA. That's a little bit crazy, right? But what I want to do is watch and start studying it to see if that's the area where it starts to gain traction. So once it pops into it, then it pops over, I don't mind, you know, I'm watching this area. It's the area that's important, right? So when it breaks back under, I have my confirmation, and then we're off to the races, reshorting. And my second reshort here, I did like 200 shares, right? I'm trying to, you know, manage my risk accordingly so I can still have lock in a good day. And the beauty is that while I'm doing this, you know, the whole tech sector was rolling over. So if you look at the tech sector, you know, the QQQs, you'll see that it was trending down the whole day. So the gap filled, then that first bounce failed off, and then you got this nice bear flag here. And so rather than trading the QQQs, right, I want a little bit more leverage. So I trade the futures market. And, right, it's just off to the races here, right? So it's this thing fails off. We short into the first pop. And then, you know, I'm subsequently playing some of these bear flags and, you know, the rest of the trades. And, you know, it ends up being a pretty good day. You don't have to do too much. You need to trade them around back and forth. But the key is to really start hunting for the patterns. And you can trade futures even after hours. So just something to kind of, keep mind of is that, you know, you can use a lot of different instruments to play a sector and really, really elongate those gains. So hopefully that helps. And let me know if you guys have any questions. I anticipate that, you know, probably the Nasdaq will bounce soon, but, you know, it's slowly grinding down at this point. When it bounces, who knows, but you can start to see, right, that, you know, we're kind of at this key level of support, and so we're starting to really bust down, but we are also getting oversold, so we have to be kind of mindful of that. So hopefully that helps, folks. Let me know if you have any questions, and take care. I look forward to hearing from you guys.